That's the reason why even enemy country, Cebu City, is also was cemented part by part, part by part. Sometimes good for the local people, but bad for the general thoroughfare traffic. So these are the questions that hands off, hands. I said, oh, do you make something out of this? How can I make something out of this? I have no control. Before, maybe the congressman gets a part of the, it passes through them, everyone's awarding, but they get a part of that for their, you know, political watches. But no, they're separated completely, detached from all decision making. So again, the game is the decisions are there in central Imperial Manila. And of course, recommended by their local regional officers. And you can see the patches of construction jumping from one place to another. It's not done continuously. It can be done, and sometimes it's not even done at night. Where no, there's no traffic, everybody stops on weekends, nobody works. This is a normal problem.
That answer your question. Okay, Arita Sapika side, let's hear the publisher of Turjak magazine, very interesting name, Pepe Soriano.
Turjak lang ako. Sa representative sa UWA, ma'am, hindi niya, sige mag-utak tour, sige ka, sorry. Hindi sa implementation na to sa UWA, hindi sa binabiktima sa Yolanda. No? Pero kung naisubot ko na ang UWA, di lang kay itong mga trabaho sa gawas, sa mga senato, kung nasa budget na i-allocate para sa itong mga biktima na to sa Baguio, Yolanda, sa Northern Cebu. Kasi ang idea kayo, o say, status na bago.
Ah, okay. So OWWA, with the in partnership with the province of Cebu, para sa katong nabiktima sa calamiting Yolanda Sir Pepe, we have established a program gitawag na to Cash Forward Assistance Program. Okay? So kaning Cash Forward Assistance Program, temporary employment ni siya for those affected member OFWs and their families. Okay, so atong mga beneficiary at ani katong who were active OWWA members at the time that the calamity took place, happened. Okay, so dito sa Northern Cebu, ako mo ihatag ni Nesty, kay siya itong usa sa mga coordinator dito, kinsa itong mga munisipyo o pila ka mga beneficiaries ang ato ang nahatagan o temporary employment or cash forward assistance program katong naapiktaran sa Baguio nga Yolanda sa Northern Cebu.
Okay, bayong buntag. So ang pipila sa mga municipalities na ito ang nahatagan sa itong cash forward assistance program dito sa Northern Cebu, mo ang kinadaghanan yun o mga beneficiaries mo ang daan bantayan. No, and then sa Bantayan Island, nasa Sugod, Cebu, asa pa rin ito? Medellin, sa, I think, Tudela, o sa Camotes Island also. So, ato sila ang mga badly affected by the typhoon Yolanda. So, mawagin to sila ang ato ang nanganin mga beneficiaries ani nga program. So, moto, they work for 15 days. So, after sila pagtrabaho, 15 days, moto maghihatagan sila o sweldo para usad sa pag-meet sa ilang mga immediate needs sa ilang kasatag sa mga kuanan, households. So, moto siya ang programa para sa mga victims sa typhoon Yolanda in Northern Cebu.
Okay, sa ang ato asang siwa, ang nag-prioritize sa mga ang sinawag ani na pick sa mga project na i ang LGU, may LGU man atong i-contract. Kung sa man ilang ikinahanglan, for example, i-repair baro na ilang simbahan na nag-uba whether in ang plaza na by clean up or asa may na by mga bridges na nabungkag. So kana pinaagi sa ato ang siwa ang mga pamilya sa miyembro nga OFW na hatagan og temporary employment. Ato nga mga proyekto ang ilahang watunon. So with that temporary employment, ato silang hatagan og sweldo. Okay, so mauna ang siwa. Part na nato ana ang probinsya sa Cebu o ang mga munisipyo nga natigtaran yun sa Bagyo nga Yolanda. And Sir Pepe, nahuman na ang ato ang programa. Okay na ta ana. So, last year man to? Last year ko na ito, na paid off, na payout sa mga beneficiaries nato.
So, katong ito ang cash card assistance program, wala lang ito na ito i-implement din sa Cebu, but also sa katong mga earthquake victims sa Bohol. So, mo ito nga, gidungan na ito siya o ka na implement.
Donar ba ko na itong gan nga, grabe mo kayo kadaos sa Yolanda, no? Diba? O balik ka ba ko na si Yolanda? Still right. Araw mga ayaw pa sa ilo. Question, Sir Gilbert, Papari? From Love Radio. Then after you is Nonoy Balcon.
Okay, good morning everyone. Especially to our panelists, Dr. Kusumbing and Sir Henry and others. My question is addressed to Sir John of Norkis. Sir, is Norkis Trading is the only distributor of Hauji motorcycle in the entire country? And is Norkis Trading selling also a battery-operated motorcycle?
To the answers, as far as being the only partner of our Hauja China in the Philippines, yes, we're an exclusive dealer here in the Philippines for Hauja motorcycles. And as far as the battery-operated motorcycles, our partners in China do have Haojin. The Haojin brand does have China battery-operated motorcycles, but as I mentioned also earlier, they're very particular about the research and development. So where they are in their research and development now is that they do have battery-operated motor bikes, e-bikes, you know, that are very famous in China, that are used all over the big cities because of certain city ordinances that they're not allowed to use gas-powered motorcycles within a certain area of the city. But where they are in the research and development is that they have found out that, as my grandfather has mentioned earlier, that it is very hard to dispose of these batteries. So where they are now is I don't think they want to send it out to the international use yet until they find a way to dispose these without affecting the environment. And we also share the same sentiment that, especially here in the Philippines, where our systems are not, our systems for that type are basically non-existent. Now, how do we dispose of these batteries, these electric batteries, when they are no longer used? Now, and I'm sure that compared to other parts of the existing motorcycle units that we have now, these batteries are fairly consumable and they last only a short time. So if we start to sell, I think we also still have to also think about how do we dispose of these batteries, because in the span of 2 or 3 years, we will have a lot of batteries to be disposing.
Okay, thank you. Nonoy Balcon from DYRF.
Problematic na to asinawas na sa inyong listahan para dito mabalik kagamit ang sa Indonesia.
Okay. With regards to kanang overseas employment, ang ato uramang yung permit mabutang dayon sa una-una ang mga problema sa mga OFWs na tuas gawas. Okay, so sa ato ang opisina, ang OWWA ang gahandog na register din sa Region 7. Okay, sa atong last year, we have handled a total of 452 welfare cases. Average lang sa dili lang sa atong rehiyon, Cebu, Bohol, Negros Oriental, or Sibihor. So yung ana, kadaghan ang problema nga ito sa gawas. Pero, Kani mga problema ha sa good sir, atong ipaabot ninyong tanan ng ato ang opisina, ato good ning giatiman o giaksyonan atong ikontak ng ato ang nagkadaiya, ng mga overseas posts na ito sa gawas, parang kaning mga nitako ng mga pamilya sa problema sa ilang mga family ay membro sa pamilya na ito sa gawas, maaksyonan o masolusyonan. Okay, dili lang mga sa OWWA ang nagtabang ana in kaso na OWWA nga na pero one country one team approach marita. So the Department of Labor of course and the Department of Foreign Affairs kita sa OWWA o sa PUEA mo na sila ato ang gitabangan in kaso nga ang worker ang migrant worker na to sa gawas makasugat o problema.
Unsa may kasagaran mga kaso nga ito ba?
Kasagaran gyud sir. Ang prone mong gyud kaayo sa sa problema katong mga trabahante nga itawag nato o household service workers kanang nasa balay.
Domestic
workers kanang nasa balay kay prone gyud na sila sa abuse especially kay lain-lain mang gyud ta kultura. So take the case for example sa Middle East. Lahi tag kultura gyud. Dili usahay magkasinabot. So katong nasa balay maotoy or mga maltreatment or abuses sa ilahang mga foreign employers, mao gyud na ang kasagaran ng problema ng atong masugatan.
Salamat sa
okay, thank you. Next, from Lloyd J. Lloyd.
Gets. Now, do you have a question? I'm wondering, did you have safety tips to the buyers before you deal with the motorcycles? And you give them some safety tips how to handle motorcycles so that accidents will be minimized, if not
okay, thank you so much, Mr. Horado. As far as for us, our direct advocacy as a company is we do have the safety tips. No? Of course, we always make sure that you have your helmet and always make sure that your motorcycles are conditioned, no, to be on the road. But one advocacy or one proactive part of our safety riding advocacy for our customers or people who are not even our customers, no, at Norkis is that we're very aggressive in our marketing as far as visiting areas. It's called the extra. We call it the extra fun vaganza, where we visit a lot of the main cities and not so main cities around the Philippines. I think last year we had over 100 of these. We're pulong-pulong, no? What we do is we invite the LTO, members of the LTO, sometimes it's the head, the jefe of the LTO of that area, who will come to speak, to have a forum, no, in the morning of our events, to speak to not only our riders, the riders of Haujian motorcycles, but it's open to everybody. If somebody is walking around the street, we would invite them to come around. I think Norkis and the motorcycle industry as a whole is very concerned about this. So, and I think it's also we would also like to pass it on to the local government to help in enforcing these laws for safety. So, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
There are a lot of abuses in the village. Why is it that when there's some other women are asked, are you still willing to go? They said, they're still willing. Even though there are some abuses, even then, give up a matay, they abuse, give them lupus. But they're not out of them. Oh, what to do?
Sir, ang kanang pagpanabaw sa gawas mong order, it's a choice, diba? It's a choice. And honestly, diba, kaning ako mga domestic workers na to, nga, napubos yun, or ganahan yun, ng wato sa gawas, it's because of the fact na dili man yun, para kasagaran yun, ang kanaan mo ang ma-interview niya, ang ilahang yung rason, nga nga nung wato sa gawas, as a household service worker, it's because mas dako dito sa window. Okay, mas dako. Ang atong standard contract ana nila, $400 for an HSW, as compared sa anin sila dinhi. niya kani atong mga household service workers na ani mga bata nga gipaiswila na ani nga mga pamilya nga gibuhi. So mo na sir ang kiswildo nga ilang kitaon dito mao gyud ang pirmero ang numero unong rason nga nganong manglagda sila. And ako lang sa ipaabot nga dili man san tanan nga household service workers wala swerte sa ilang pagpanarbaho sa gawas. Ang ma-highlight raman gud, ang makita raman gud nato ang katong mga naabuso nga mga household service workers. There are also OFWs, mga household service workers nga they have success stories sa ilang pagpanarbaho sa gawas. That's why sa OWWA, usa sa amuang mga institutional program, kaling gitawag na mo og MOFIA, nga Model OFW Family of the Year Award, nga ipakita diha ang success story sa OFW family, nga para itong ma-erase lang po sa itong mga huna-huna, nga basta mo ato tagawas, mao giniresulta na ito, mga priso ta, abusaran ta, no, hindi lang mansad ka na. There are success stories of our OFW.
In my association with Sani Osmania, University Congressman, he said that if a nation can stay on as an agricultural country, it will never progress. It should be an industrial country. Do you believe that?
We can never be industrial. We don't have the basic industries like steel and all that. And know-how, technology, chemicals, know-how. All industrial companies have brilliant minds to produce new products, new machines, and all these new developments. Unfortunately, our educational system did not allow that. However, to answer your question, it's better that we are agricultural so that 60 or 70% of the people live, or even more, live in the countryside. The reason they left is they don't have enough food. They don't have the know-how to produce high-value crops or to produce. And then you have the weather against them, because we are outside the tropical side, where we have 20, 25, 30 typhoons throughout the year that destroy our crops. But there's always room, as you can see, those who are going to the country, retirees going to the country, they in small parts of land, they can produce high-value crops. Different kinds of trees and vegetables and poultry and animals they raise. But unfortunately, people in the countryside farmers, because of lack of education or lack of guidance from the government, or do not know how to use the land or to make the land productive. So it's always constantly poor. The countryside is constantly poor, with some exception maybe in Mindoro, because it has irrigation. Some exception maybe in Malaysia, it has irrigation. In some parts where there is irrigation, you can harvest rice 2 or 3 times a year. But in the other parts, the other islands, you are totally dependent on the weather, on the rain. And it doesn't come that like the first 4 or 5 months of this year, it was all very hot weather. It's only now that the rains come, maybe too late for planting. So, but we are not industrial, we are not agricultural, we are a consumer-controlled society. Only 24 billion remittances coming from the OFWs, our and some heroes go to the malls. Do you know that SM alone has a cash flow of 5 billion pesos a day? And most of these old mall owners, they also have other businesses. They go into real estate. So it's like vacuum cleaner. So all our people, except our middle class and upper class, spend their money. As soon as they get their money, they spend their money. They don't even know how to save. Yeah. So ang kulang kasi lack of they were born poor, so kulang gani ang IQ, and they can also pass school because they've been dropped out in school. So they end up as construction workers, laborers, all that. We know this because our business is mostly poor. CBE, that is our business. And over the past few years, rice has been great, going up in prices, like from 25 pesos per kilo now, it's 50, 55. So, and but the salaries of these poor do not increase. They're only 10 to 15,000 a month. And if they have 5 or 6 children, wala na, what will they get the money then? So survival na lang yan. So the challenge is to this presidential system does not even address the poverty. It is more for the rich. It is an elitist government right now. When it is controlled by families, by dynasties, by natural, they will always try to enrich themselves so they have enough war chest for the next election.
Okay. Senator, a very quick comment. I don't know about that.
Thank you, sir. Roberto. You know, Sir Lloyd, Philippines is, whether we believe it or not, we are an agricultural country. We citizens who are not willing to become farmers. And I stereotypes ato ng farmers niya ni Musang Asia, di ba? So gusto nato tanan na ata sa urban areas, na trabaho ta sa Makati, Manila. So that's the failure of our government. That is why we need to revisit our constitution in order to give more powers, no, to the countryside or the rural areas. Para mabalik nato ang atong agricultural supremacy in Southeast Asia.
Let me mention an experience when I went to Thailand. No, I thought that grapes are grown only in temperate countries, in where there is snow, where they have 4 seasons. But when I visited Thailand, I went to a rice paddy, and in between the rice paddy, they're growing grapes. Why? Because the governments send technicians to the farms and help the farmers come up with new ideas and introduce them to new ideas, how to plant more productive, more profitable plants, etc., etc. So even if they are unschooled, they are productive because they are guided in the honest way. The technicians who know what they're doing and who are really sincerely teaching the people.
Okay, sa rin pa mga tanda doon, sa Mr. Delgado, ano na lang isumpay na si Andy Malata.
Thank you, Sam. In addition to the statement of Sir A.Q. and Sir Henry, that is true in the Philippines because some of our people, our students, are trained to become educated in order to employ themselves in different companies. Because some of them, they do not go to agriculture, to farming, because lapis na malag, ano, bulpe na malag, papil, alam ko nitan. Yan ka itong naitsuho nila nga, waka eskwela, buhay lang patusok mahan. Kaya din na sila mo gunit o, kuhan lapok, din na gunit o yuta. So, we are trained to be employed, not to be PAGMED. Because as mentioned earlier, that partners in the Philippines is the most downgraded profession. But as we have known, in Japan, in Thailand, in Vietnam, partners are very rich because according to Sir Hildre, they have studied in Los Baños, UP Los Baños. So kita kay ang ato gobyerno may tapang na ma-highly doon natin high technology sa ato farming mo na pobre niya punta. So na kay bawa na si Joy Anto. Mato kas buke, alas 9 po tanto aga magyong, gainom, ga tabako. Unya na sapo mato sa basakan. Mo na mato kag basakan dito, duha ka kahon, duha tulong kahon, upat kahon. Unya ang ami na mga lima nga to mapo kasako inigani. So di ko improve ang pagkinabuhi sa farmers. Usag yung rason, number one, na ang gobyerno din tabang. Thank you.
Excellent from Freeman and Rajuna Baya.
From your earlier statement, sir, that the Singaporean people before they were under way of development. I mean to say that they were underdeveloped in areas. For some of the areas of Singapore, there is some people, PAPI marijuana, even in the public areas. Now, what do you think? Why they have a very, weak change when the new government was set up by Lee Kuan Yew? And do you think that what type of government he adopted, or the system of government that he have exercised before, and do you think that is it applicable here in our country? But for example, if we adopt the terrorism, do you think our the minds of our people here and our environment and the lack of our development, do you think we can cope up that? We can cope the system that the Singaporean people, or the Singaporean government, are acting for exercise?
It's not only the political system, it is also the kind of leaders. So, na timing ba na if when you came into the picture? And already there is in place a parliamentary type of government, because Malaysia is parliamentary and federal. So that's what they have. And the basic philosophy of really Lee Kuan Yew's governance is quality. Number two, honesty and efficiency. Those three must be together take away quality, efficiency, and honesty. Without one, the other will not work. They have to be together. So that is what he not only declared, but he also practiced. Now, you cannot be efficient if you don't have quality people. Oh, it is also farcical if you are efficient but dishonest. So those two are Siamese twins. This is what underneath the fundamentals of this governance, to make sure that this government is efficient, but he must have good people to do that. His people must be honest, and he must also have honest people there. So he even fired a cabinet member who was with him from the very start because he found this person was entering into corrupt deals. So all of these needed is a combination really of honesty, efficiency, and leadership. So now, one way of ensuring continuity of those components, this system of government, our presidential system, as we have seen, breeds corruption. But the federal system and the parliamentary one is reduce, if there is any, possibly reduce corruption, because we have separate leaders in each state depending on number of states we will be divided into. And it will be a local government, so that you see, the voters know personally the candidates in close quarters. It is like voting for your mayor and governor. You know who they are, that's why many cities with good mayors and leaders come out to be very progressive. Sometimes the people forget already what's wrong with national government, because they're happy with the local government.
What is your proposal, or how do you propose that the charter change? Is it totally or? No,
is it partially? Because KPM and Tapok-Tapok Pradasa is the overhaul, yes, of the present constitution. Because we cannot just shift from unitary presidential to federal parliamentary if we will just amend the constitution. It must be revised. Because that is a major operation, kumbaga.
Okay, thank you. Cesar Albon from DYRC.
Thank you very much, Raja. To the federal advocates, can yes or no to constitutional convention can be included, possible in the next year's presidential elections through the efforts of the federal advocates of federal politics?
That is one of the options, sir. Our movement now is urging the members of Congress to listen to the people. You know? Under the present constitution, there are many methods of calling for amendments or revisions. One of those is yung yes or no. But ang gusto namo is the Congress itself meeting in a joint session to call themselves, sila mismo ang call for constitutional convention. So no need na yes or no na plebiscit. But ang atong butaran, next election, i-apil na to ang pagpili mismo sa delegates sa atong constitutional convention.
Okay,
last question or follow-up question?
Akong iliwag ang atong pangutana diri sa two ladies. After 2010 presidential elections, President Noynoy Aquino tasked Vice President Binay to lead the concerns of the OWWA's overseas Filipino workers. In behalf of the bigwigs of POA and OWWA, how would you rate Vice President Binay's performance, who recently resigned from the post?
You are just rating.
Okay, so the Office of the Vice President for Migrant Affairs, OWWA, lahit mangod ni, we are under the Department of Labor and Employment. Although, in some ways, magkakuan na sa gini, magka-interrelate when it comes to our functions. Ang Office of the Migrant Affairs, basically on cases, on welfare cases, they're concentrated on the welfare cases involving OWWA. Mo na makita na ito sa balita na kanyang mga ipang-priso, ipang-tabangan ni Ninay, ang katong anak nga na bidaw, kay mo na ang ilang concern. Problema ng anak nga, ang anak na yun, ang amo, OWWA man yun, under the Department of Labor, dili ng kana ang amuang function. Although, we act on the welfare cases involving OFWs, but then, there are other things, other areas, other programs, other services na amuang giatiman for the OFWs. And, dili give me directly in contact with the Office of the Migrant Affairs, DFA, with siguro with the Department of Foreign Affairs, kay kami sa OWWA at PAPI, we are under the Department of Labor. And basically, wala raman sa board na apektahi ang mga opisina sa pag-resign kay this is a known fact na ang opisina established na din na OWWA, PAPI, and maski yung sa mga opisina na related to the migrant workers, established na ng office. Maski kinsa pa na ang mo-hold sa office, the programs and services would remain. Hindi okay. Naman ang agad sa kinsay na dala.
Kung siya change, unya, lain niyang isgutan na magpabilin nga ang kagamanan sa Mandaue, din sa Sumpo, friendly to the mga businessmen. Pwede akong ipangutana. Imong bang sagaganon, imong apo, pagkamayor, aron na magpabilin business friendly ang siyudad sa Mandaue.
What do you say, Anna? Tapang lang ko. I only hope that he will run, but he has still to decide. Pero, of course, everybody, business, our friends in business, the business community, like him to run. Most of the people I talk to from business, they like him to run. So he can continue the good job that was started by Mayor Norkis. Murang, ano, the same, they have the same, they have the same model, they have the same direction, they have the same philosophy. Ang ilang vision, that mission sa Mandaue is almost the same. So I hope. It's still a big decision, but we will know by October.
That must agree, no, to be followed by Mr. Delgado, Dr. Alpi, and then si Dr. Nag-iskot man si Sir N. yung kanina may tuwag sa kausapan. Ang kapasumpay lang yan po din kay Igor Magusa, mga malamon, ngay why na yung permanenteng butang ng kalibutan na gawas kausapan. Kasi in English pa, there is nothing permanent in this world except change. Magkatubag yan po si Brother Henry Dini po ang pagkutan ng Excellent Group. Huwag ba kayo posibilidad sa isgutan pero nga change o kining isgutan federalism? Huwag ba kayo posibilidad nga usbo na ito pausap eh kung niya mahimol ng stating ato nga turok ng mga nagro nga regional sa ato sa Pilipinas? Huwag kayo kausapan ng Pilipinas, hindi. Huwag kayo mga taga-uwa nga huwag kayo kusgawa sa pagitan kwarta. Kung may tabo nga mahimo ng federal, dili magkandala sa usunod ng Pilipinas, huwag kayo mga kusgawa. E dala naman, yung dala naman po, truth yun. Huwag kayo ulit magkayo. Ang pangunta na, huwag kayo posibilidad yung mag-change ang Pilipinas. Kausapan as Sir N.K. Resulting change. Huwag kayo sa mahimong federal nga, mausap yun ka ang kanang konstitusyon, pinagis pagbutang o glabo. Wala na lang.
Okay, sige. Salamat, Bishop.
I'm sorry, tinapin mo, Senyor.
Hindi ba din mo usap, kalimutan na.
Sige, sige.
O, sige, tabi.
Oh. Sige, salamat si Mong Wally. Henry, Sir Henry, Mong Tubag.
Salamat kayo, Sir Max. Kitang tanang gustong kausapan, kausapan for the better ang atong gusto. No? Ang imong concern about God, love, naaman na, bisag sa akong present constitution, ang preamble mismo na to, we, the Filipino people, imploring the aid of Almighty God. Kahit kita mga Pilipino, namo tayo Ginoo. No? Majority sa atong Christians, some are Muslim, but naapon sila Ginoo. No? Gamay na siguro ang ITS, ng mga agnostics na wala yung Ginoo. No? So, pagpapili yun ang siya, sir, sa atong constitution. That is why, karong may mga issues na nito mao, like, same-sex marriage, kanang siguro kini separation of church and state. Ato nang tukikong sa bagong constitution. Kay karon di ba tagakuhag tax? Di ba? Usa na sa maaglihan ng mga issues na i-discuss na to during sa convention. So siguro sir, kung mahimo ka ang tuhon na wala tayo delegates, tuhon. Di ba? Pagpapili na kayo, it's open for everybody. So, we can, lecture na, siguro kining uban pa ang mga issues, no? Na mukta sa church, sa state, o katang sa morality sa mga Pilipino. Siguro ato nang i-appeal na to sa institution.
Okay. Salamat. Ato na tayo kayo si Mr. Delgado. Kaya pagkabungta na. Sige, sir.
Hello, good morning everyone. I would just like to address this question to Mr. John Eric, Assembly Chair. Good morning.
Morning.
Regarding the Howdy motorcycles, which is in partnership with Norkis Motor, I know that the marketing team is very aggressive in regards to reaching out to the rural areas since they are the ones who are actually using a lot of motorcycles. I would just like to ask if Norkis has a after sales department which they can handle with regards to repair replacement of engine parts since you know in the provinces it's bulok yung kaya
tong as far as the after sales we actually have in place and always continuously getting better our after sales service. So, Norkis is not the only company with their own personal mechanics, but what we have done to level up our after-sales services, we have identified the top 200 parts that are most wear and tear, you know, for our units. And since we have been with Howdy has been in the Philippines for over 4 years now. We understand that this is the time to level up our after-sales service because of the regular, normal wear and tear. So all of our branches do have the top 200 wear and tear spare parts. And not only do we have that, but we also have, we can also guarantee the availability of all our parts, of all our motorcycles. How can we guarantee this? Norkis is not only an importer or the partner of Howdy China, but we are also the assembler of the motorcycles. And these motorcycles are assembled right here in Cebu, you know, in Compostela, in our factories in Compostela. So this is how we can guarantee our aftermarket, the availability of our aftermarket parts. It's because these motorcycles that are brought in to the Philippines from China are knocked down, completely knocked down. So no matter if those parts are not available in the branch, for example, because it's wear and tear and top 200 mostly are fast moving, if they are not available in the branch, they can always be ordered from our main office here in Cebu, because those parts are readily available as we are assembling those units in right here in Diloan and Compostela.
Okay. Before Kenneth, ari nata ni ari nata Dr. Alpi.
Ali question to Sir Henry. I also like the federal form of government. But my question is this: the promoters of the federal form of government, so that our country is agricultural, is there a specific program of action in order to fulfill the federal form of government regarding the progress of our farmers and to the workers, and how to convince our local governments, such as the congressmen, senator, and other NGO leaders for this program? Is there any specific program of action that would convince the people to support the federal form of government?
I think I'm not yet in the position to discuss about it, because we're still on the process of ang reference pa nato, point of reference is we agree on the need to change our constitution, and our proposition is that federalism is better than the current unitary form of government, and parliamentary form is better than the current presidential form. But time will come, sir. Our delegates to the constitution, to the convention, our leaders will convene and meet and discuss about the specifics as to the priorities, no? And the particular issues per regions. It will be tackled maybe
as time progresses, it will, we will come to that, sir.
Can I have a follow-up question? How did you being convinced? How the group convinced you? What is the basis? What is the framework? Why do you join with them?
Yes, sir. No. Originally, I'm from Samar. I'm a Walay-Walay. And I migrated to the Cebu now. By choice, I'm already a Cebuano. Siguro, nagkapo din sa atok, no, mga anak. And I was a political science student and I studied law also. So I have may, backgrounds in governance, in politics. And I really observed personally that the presidential form is not working because for a century or for more than 100 years, no? Ungovernment sa presidential and it seems na nabiyaan dyan ka. And makita mo ta sa KPM nami slogan niya, if you expect a different result doing the same thing again and again, that is political insanity. So we have to change the system first and there we can expect a different result. Meaning let's try another form or another system which is more fit for the Filipinos, being Asians. Kaya makita na sa mga neighboring countries na ito, mga parliamentary form of government na sila. And it worked for them. I think, mo-work po na ito. Kaya our present condition right now is the proof that it did not work. No? So there are some skeptics that now, siguro, halos matatanan na convinced na there is a need to revise the constitution, but some are, you know, ay mga business interest na ikuandaan na ay mga issues na yun na ipabuto na this is not the time. So I think it's time na mo-educate ta sa atong mga kauban, sa atong family, friends, peers, na this is the right time. Okay. Ganun sa apaman. Diba? Dapat ngayon na. Okay. Thank you. Kenneth Rivera. And then the last will be Dr. OWWA.
First to the Sir Henry. Since you are advocating for change in constitution, and the mode of changing the constitution that you choose is by constitutional convention, which is really the right thing to do, because kung magsalita sa Kongreso na to, vested interest lang gihapon nila. In fact, to cite one example is, this constitution of ours, present constitution, is asking for the first Congress nga dapat unta is to abolish the dynasty, kanang sa political dynasty gani, pero kung sa'yo lang ibuhat, wala. So, now, my question is this. What will be the process of choosing delegates to this proposed constitutional convention?
Two sets. First is the elected delegates, and the second are the appointed. To be safe, nano. As I have said, ang present constitution nato, all are appointed by the president, ni Kuri. Walay elected, meaning it's not the representative of the people. Okay, wala man sa nag-select. So, karon we have to elect our delegates. But base na ay sayo nga, you know, wabot na panahon niya ang i-elect nato based na po sa traditional politics, di ba? So it's safer na naapuntay appointed. Mobilita katong mga experts, katong mga statesmen, katong not the politicians, katong mga walay interest. So, duha ang among i-proposer, the elected delegates and the appointed.
And then, ang number of delegates, so, malapak. So, tako lang po sa tatlong duha. Still in the process. Thank you for that. But, to the Norkis group, especially sa mga motorcycles, no? When we go into business, there is what we call as social responsibility. My concern is this. What's since as we all know, mga accidents in the roads, majority of that involve motorcycles. Then, kung saan ang mga steps nga as social responsibility sa Norkis Group ba, i-cashier nga ito, especially sagat magkula ni mga nag-drive good sa mga motorcycles. As a proven fact, sagat, wala lisensya, wala marehistro. Then, kung sa may ato akang ika-ambit nga ito sa kapilingban para maminos-minosan kining certain na mga cases, at the same time, ma-prevent ang mga accidents. Because prior to this, Manggod, nakita po Manggod Igod, once ka itong i-open ka niya ang market, as I can remember, pagpalit Manggod ang mga vehicles, there is what we call, karanakan ni ability to pay ganit. Iabot na itong panahon, i-open na siya sa market, muna na, makapalit na lang kung mga motorcycles or any vehicles with a certain small amount. In fact, ganit, gamit sa mga bakitong for especially motorcycles. So, what social responsibility steps ka nga ni buhat sa ito ang revision?
For us, no, especially for me personally, safety driving is a very big, thing for me personally, and I try to reflect this in everything that we do, especially in our marketing of our brand. And just a little bit of a background, no, I went to high school in the United States. I spent 2 years there in Missouri, which I believe has one of the strictest driving strictest process in attaining your driver's license. When you are 16, I believe you're allowed to get your driver's license, and about 70 or 80% of my classmates, no, wakakoha sa first night, the first, and there's a lot of things involved in that, and I try to reflect that. But when I joined the company, when I joined the motorcycle part of our company, it was very important to me. That's why not only are we aggressive in marketing our products or our motorcycles, but while we are doing that, we always make sure that we are very aggressive in inviting the LTOs to attend what we call extra fun vaganzas, where we have 2-day events and marketing our products. We start off that event by inviting the LTOs to have a seminar open to everybody. But also to get to your question of how do we approach those people who are illegal, who are using their vehicles illegally? We have a strict process in before we release. Although most of the motorcycles now, even four wheels, have a very low down payment, no? Which opens the market to a lot more people, right? Correct. We have down payments even for four wheels that are 10,000 nowadays, 10,000 to 15,000. The motorcycle down payment, I believe now can be up to, can be down to 1,500 or even lower sometimes. Our company has always been, as my grandfather, as our chairman always echoes, we always look for quality. Not only, of course, the quality of our products is number one, but also the quality of our customers. No, we have a strict process in the CI because we are also a financing company. No, motorcycles cannot be financed via the banks. So we have to survive in this industry. You have to be able to finance, to be a financing company at the same time, a retail financing company. So this is also our advocacy. Now we always look for the quality customers, strict CI with the proper driver's license, with the proper requirements. Our company even asks for more than maybe other companies do as far as the requirements. So this is how we keep how we keep ourselves in line, no? Internally, we are finding the right customer and we're making sure that these are the right people that we want to do business in and to do business with, and also kind of being our ambassadors on the street. Kasi naka-hauje man sila, so that means they're with Norkis and hauje. So we want to make sure that they're also projecting our company in the right way. Not only one way, but also to go both ways. No, so this is how we kind of keep track with our customers, that they are the right people, and we would like to also see as far as being motorists on the street. No, and we another advocacy that we have is we also are tied in with a lot of motorcycle groups in Luzon, sponsoring them as far as their advocacies of to put it plainly, they want to make sure that they show the public that the motorcyclists are not the nuisances on the road, but they can also be very helpful to the community. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
You know, panelin ang those information, so I'm now quite optimistic that the sustainability aspect of Haji is not like the other China company whom I know. You know what, I'd like to share to the group, you know, not to discourage the listeners, but I have now two units of QQ car and my without. Reason why I bought these cars for my kids during the school days. And it's now in our house, not in the running condition, for the simple reason that there's no available spare parts in Cebu. Actually, the service station closed, no? There's no available spare parts. I hope this will not happen in Haji, no? Another comment, sir, is the reason why people from Thailand and Vietnam can cultivate their farm any time of the year as you wish because of the Mekong River. They are not dependent to the weather. They have water all the time. And then to the OWWA in Italy, na mamaligya nga itong balot to ipanada if you will roam around their public places. And I asked from a reliable source, how many Filipinos are now here in Italy? Tingon siya, 200,000. And only roughly 100,000 of these 200,000 Filipinos now in Italy has the working visa. And these are the most likely people who will be victims for abuse because they will be kapit-patalim na lang ka, wala kay working visa, nakaka-overstaying ka. Unsa bigihin mo ni sa uwa, ma'am?
Okay, for those nga na mga scenario, sir, nga in countries nga there are a lot of Filipinos who doesn't have the work permits na necessary for them to stay there, to legally stay there, OWWA has overseas posts. We have overseas posts, and ang among trabaho dere sa region, dere sa atong lokal, maunasad na ang ilang gitrabaho nato sa gawas. Okay, so our overseas posts, our persons, our welfare officers in the overseas posts, ilan ang trabaho, ilan ang lookout, that's one of their main functions, sir, to like mobile na sila for ipa-document ng mga tawhana. Okay, so a lot of our undocumented workers are now getting documented. Kay usali sa ato ang trust na katong tanang nanalbaho sa gawas, we could have them documented. Why? Because in kaso manggot nga magka-problema, sayo na nato pagpanyika. Like for example, sa political crisis now in Libya and Yemen. So katong mga documented, dali kakaayo na to pag-assist in the repatriation. So, our overseas post, sir, tanang lugar na daghan tag overseas Filipino workers na agyoy overseas post.
And so, we would like to request our panelists to give their parting statements. Ano? Magunata ni Sir John Eric.
I just want to express my deepest thanks for everybody for coming here, for supporting PAPI, and also for supporting a lot of the ideas that also the Norkis group and my grandfather especially has. Thank you very much. And again, as he has mentioned, that this venue is made available now at least once a month to this group. So what we ask of you is please take advantage. Come here, but you know, if you would like to have meetings here, please let us know, and we will do our best to support any way we can. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Parting shot from OWWA, Nisti, and Odell.
Okay, again, we thank you for inviting us here, for giving us the chance to promote the programs and services of the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration for the OFWs and their families. So for those kato mga OFWs and their families may na concerns or gusto nga mo avail sa ato ang mga programa, you may just visit our office. So ato ang regional office sa OWWA na sa second floor, Dolores 7 building na sa Gordo Avenue, corner General Maxilom Avenue, Cebu City. Or you may just call us at these numbers, mga official numbers, sa landline at sa itong numero, 03-2254-3199. Okay. Okay.
Excuse me. Now, take pamphleting. I will just distribute. Okay, sige. Ang ina ba sa inyong office, doon sa Imakulada?
Yes, doon sa Imakulada.
Ma'am Odell. Martin Shah.
Okay, so once again, dalang salamat, Sir Sam. Thank you kaayo sa pag-invita naman. Medyo soki na gandaan. OWWA o PAPI. Okay, and dalang salamat sa tanan and for among giawhag katong naamoy mga miyembro sa pamilya, mga kaila, mga OFWs. Please visit the office sa tanang concerns ninyo regarding sa ila. Okay? So, dalang salamat.
Okay, from KPM, Sir Henry, tumalakad.
Sir Sam, salamat. And sa mga members sa PAPI, naamo po babae, mami. Members sa mami, maraming salamat sa inyo. I hope napakay time, sir. Siguro po kami sa Chief Justice at umisita mo para makahistorya ninyo. Pasalamat ko ni Sir Doc Norberto Susumbing, Sir John, sa upan na itong mga bisita. And gawang ako, gidalit ang mga media na magtapang sa atong advocacya kay hiling pag siya sa konstitusyon, hindi naman na para sa amin. This is for all of us.
Okay. Party shot from Chairman Dr. Norberto Susumbing Jr.
I can see that this is not a joking matter to you. But every question is a serious one because it comes from very intelligent people. So I'd like to ask you to be the purveyors of change. If we have to change, and we really have to change, as you can see from your very eyes, what's happening to the country, what's happening to our government, and why, you have your own reasons. But very clear is, party is not good news, it's a sad news, is that we have a population of 100 million, or little over now, and if my statistics or my information is correct, 80% of this population is poor, are poor, classified CBE. But we also have 30% A and B. That means the middle class and the rich and super rich. Unfortunately, the scale is over the years also tilting against the rich. So that the rich are getting richer and the poor get not only getting poor, but even increasing in numbers. So it won't be long, it will be 90% poor and 10% rich. But most of the wealth is that in the United States, some of these companies are accumulating wealth, the mega rich are being charged by the Department of Commerce for antitrust. Then as you see the papers, they get their money here from this country, but they bring their money somewhere else and invest in other countries now. Are these patriots, are these nationalists, are these people? Taking advantage of the wealth of the country. So that's why the poor is not able to improve themselves. They remain poor. They have nothing. Of course, that's so little they spend right away whatever they have. So these are parting words. Just think, what can we do to to correct the imbalance. That's right. We have our Filipino heroes going abroad. How many of them? By the millions. And from statistics, $24 billion were remitted to this country last year. Thanks to the BPO industry, about $16 billion already now in the BPO. So that instead of going abroad, they're already finding their jobs here. But where is that $40 billion going? Does it stay in the pockets of the poor? Are they able to save some money for a rainy day? What makes them build so high rise, so much high rises? Expanding, you open the newspaper, full pages, two pages, high rise of this company, high rise of this company. And all this, you read only about the rich. How about the poor? Do you hear it? So, but you have to think about it for at least the next time.
Okay, thank you so much. So, panelists, salamat po sa inyo. And we'd like to thank you again for hosting this event. Well done.